Kai'Sa, even when you pick the gyrocopter.
Okay. So it means that you could deal with the tombstone relatively well as the gyrocopter. You've got a decent kill lane when you've got Fly and Gyro on their own. So that you're not having a strength core coming in this Undying if you choose to go the K route over here. I don't mind it at all, and it secures things even more when you've got crit through. So it is going to be that support invoker as well. So I'm playing mid lane on his pucks. See how it's going to benefit LGD to go for this lineup, really prioritizing being able to push out these lanes as much as possible. How FY can play around the.
I wonder if there's more benefit on EG's lineup for like being active earlier. Like, that's one of the beautiful things about Gyro, but it's going to be interesting to see the Tiny in this situation, because this is not a Tiny IO, so it's going to be maybe a little bit slower to get online. It doesn't have that strong of a laning partner in comparison. Like, Undying can do a lot, but this won't likely be your heavy farming Tiny, and if it is, you're going to just kind of invalidate your Undying in the early stages of the game.
We are going to see Ame again doubling down on that position one Tiny, so wasn't too successful for him in the series against Na'Vi, but they've clearly prepared for this. This is their first biggest tournament that they've had since coming back from their break, so I think they're going to be taking as a big deal, especially after losing that first series.
We'll have to see if they can actually bounce back. What lane do you think has to pop off on each side? Is it the pretty obvious puck in the mid for LGD, and then EG maybe? I think like for EG it's more the supports, right, than the cores at the start of this game.
Yeah, I would say so. I think Crit's always going to have a really solid game as this Willow, so you don't have to worry quite as much about that, but it's just a matter of, are you going to get anything out of this lane coming up against Undying, who I think is ridiculous. The patch. Already seeing a tri-lane come down towards the bottom side. And with all these heroes, they have okay kill potential. If they're able to secure a first blood onto someone, that's easy game for them in Abed. Quickly snares. Yeah.
Cheeky little clean up the ward in the mid. Gives them a little bit of advantage already over Somnus. But on the outer lanes, if we're thinking where the combos are, it looks like they've switched up, so you will get the Undying starting with the Brewmaster. They got both supports down here. It's not an easy kill, though. It's such a fast hero. You want to find the CM. If Maiden shows us face, then that's an easy kill. 277 movement speed hero. Definitely the one you're aiming for. The battle begins. But it looks like it's going to be a 3-1 split on the runes. LGD getting the better at the start here.
Wisely done by FY, not actually showing himself at all in that engagement, staying in the trees, so getting a little bit worried perhaps that he was paired together with Ame towards the top side.
And Nova not able to actually find the observer in response from EG, as it is on the high ground further back. At least get rid of the pesky sentry, but Vance still Arbed in the mid lane to start with, needed after they lost the bounties. And it's going to be next Nova with Ame as expected in the top lane. Nothing unexpected to begin with here.
Pressure already starting to come out by Crit. Trying to push Ame back as quickly as he can. Sure, whenever he gets a chance, he'll be looking to get the right clicks off onto that zero armor Tiny. Already, oh. Ramses has gone and sniped.
Yoink. 3-2-8 movement speed hero. Easy to just do that. Didn't hang around for the second Corey though. So it looks like Nova should at least get his stick.
That's very important, though, having that Ring of Protection denied away from Ame. It means he's much more susceptible to that harass constant coming out from Crit, especially.
And it's always deceptive, right? Because, like, man, it's only 45 seconds. He'll be fine. It's like a creep wave and a half. The problem is that your courier has to come out again, and it moves like a slug.
Yep. Not going to be level 5 by that time.
Meanwhile, mid pretty even so far after the first wave or two. Slight lead for Somnus, but Abed did get the denying. I don't think it's on a range creep at least, though. Might make too much difference to begin with. Bot lane, a lot of pressure is being applied on both sides here, but the one who's really winning is Gyrocopter. Like, Arteezy's just being allowed to do whatever he wants. Did cost him most of his tangos already, though. However, the other side is getting low as well, and when you compare the regen battle, one side has two salves to work with, the other has none.
Yeah, it's a dangerous proposition to be coming up against this sort of stuff and see the harass constantly. Martizi through the magic.
Undying. Next over had a salve coming out. Perfect time to do so as he almost went down there and gave the first blood. But stays alive. Just looking at Arme right now, he's like, could you help me? There's no support from Tiny. Oh,
tossing back under the tower for Ramses.
They might get him here. Soul Rip as well, get him low, and that's going to be the kill. But the gold was shared because the tower did get the final club. Over. Still training with crit, but the attack animation on Dark Willow is just too good.
But that's Soul Rip. It's an insane ability.
Yeah, they nerfed it, but it didn't matter. It's still the best thing about this hero. I love that they tried to go different angles, like, all right, we can't nerf Soul Rip further, so how about we buff Flesh Golem, right? Let's make that the cool part about the hero. People still don't care about Flesh Golem. It's a nice niche idea as well, like the whole double zombie damage due to Flesh Golem, but ultimately didn't change the nature of the hero at all.
They've changed it around a little bit as well. Like previously it was percentage damage that you took just by being nearby to it as well, kind of similar to Necro, but yeah, going down to that that double damage from the roll of something a little bit different. That Soul Rip, it's the real game to be able to have both for sustain in lane as well as we saw it took off essentially half Ramsey P previous kill.
Let's quickly restart the call. Cutting out a little bit again. Bye bye, guys. Getting back in. Alright, there we go. We shall have a non-laggy, very clear Danon. Things pretty chill to start with, but Chalice in trouble here. Gets away. No! This nerf comes out and Fly will go down afterwards. Big kill obtained. FY, he might hit the deck as well. He's out of mana. But Gyro not quick enough to catch him here. Only 320 movement speed. FY gets away.
Able to scud away. Good rune control as well happening. Somnus. Getting slightly the better end of this early game against the Storm Spirit, but you know how quickly Arbed is able to flash farm as this storm in the jungle. The thing I'm worried about more for his sake is the lack of shrines on the bottom side of the map, so he doesn't have his own at his disposal. He's going to have to really work for all of that mana regen coming to him. Part of the reason, perhaps, why Crystal Maiden was picked up so early on into the draft.
And this is also the point where storms start to pray to the gods. Once the 7 minutes hits, maybe you find yourself something like a shovel would be perfect here. Or even a faded brooch. Just allowing you those
jelly
early
would be nice as well.
True. Jelly would be nice. I think you're like, optimally, you want a shovel though for the bottle, right? But like, that's the dream. Get those bounties. Rotation, crit, just getting a ward down. I don't think there's a kill to be had here, not against a puck. Unless he commits on Arbed. That's the only way this would work. Lose your abused. This is the moment to go if they want to. Arbed poking and prodding. Banging him in a little bit. Crit's going to come in now. Brandmaid's going to go down. But lose your coming off cooldown means they can't get the kill. Few attempts. Top.
Cool.
Arme playing fetch with Ramses. He doesn't like the game. And that's the kind of risk you get though. Like the moment you show crit mid, it's obvious you're alone top. And this is already proven once that it's a lane that will punish and kill off an Abaddon. So where do you like invest your resources if you're EG? Like, I just feel like the mid lane isn't gankable with your combo onto this park. He'll always get away. Unless you find him being ultra greedy.
Yeah. I find it a little odd that he's gone this Crystal Nova style, I suppose just trying to win the lane as hard as possible for Arteezy, as opposed to having this roaming ganking potential. Because I think Frostbite, again, is another ability that's being slept on by a lot of people. Because you're going to be able to lock down this puck. Can't phase shift out of it. You can lock down an invoker. It's normally quite slippery. You can stop Primal Split from coming off. Chalice reaches level 5, at level 6 rather. So, just see Fly's skill build after this. How he's going to progress once the mid game starts.
Instead, LGD are making moves again. Ramsey's just got back to lane. And he might find himself going back to the fountain. Cold Snap is there, EMP as well. No way to protect himself, and he's just dead.
Cool.
Nice little rotation. So far, impact being had. I think that is the urn on the way out now for FY.
Pretty handy.
Yep. Just looks to get more active off that as well. You have such good lanes to get.
Yeah, we can see there's a few stacks that have been put up in the jungle for both sides as well. So it's jungle time right now. Great heroes to be able to do it with the tree, obviously, on Tiny now being the main build to go for. It's very easy to quickly take down a stack like this. They've also got two closer to their Daesh jungle shrine. Quickly pick off.
Should alarm to accelerate a little. Gyro on the other side isn't really getting these stacks though, because Arbed's spending a lot of time in the jungle supplementing his farm. It means they're not going to be able to stack up easily. Crit spent a lot of time on the lane getting extra XP, which means he's not stacking this triangle. Tyr and Gyro's
really
up.
Gotten too much from it either.
No. The question is, what do you do? Once you've got six, I can see the power rotations, but what are you rotating on? Maybe the Undying? Tiny's not a kill. Puck will always escape. Even Bruce should be able to get his split off in time.
Don't really have that early kill potential.
Ramses.
Rhino.
Tornado, EMP, Cold Snap as well. Fodic Shield to try and retreat. They toss him back. They'll bring him down again. He did snipe a Coria, but it is at a price. Nope, stick keeps him alive. They didn't have an urn charge. They desperately needed that as well to get the Invoker active at this stage. And that's an easy shrine usage. Or it should be. However, Somnus. Oh, he's coming in right now. FY says, yes, please. Give me the urn. But they'll trigger the shrine in time. And that'll force them back as Arbed did TP in. See how badly they want to get this Invoker online. Once he has the Cold Snap urn combo, he can just begin to rapidly rotate across the map.
But yeah, you need that. You can see he's going at the first, second item. Even before boots, he's able to pick it up. They'll spot the rotation through back into the mid lanes. They'll know not to try and gank Somnus, but.
Yeah, plenty of time to respond to him as well. He's 300 movement speed.
Yeah, I'd say this is playing into EG's hands, though, being able to have that slight delay in proceeding. You know, it's the 9.5 minute mark. There's only been 5 kills. Snail's pace for the current meta.
Although things might ramp up now. Dream Call comes out.
Yeah, they want to make stuff happen.
Gyro. Then on the max range, Arteezy refusing to go down easily. Terrorize being charged up, cancelled in the end. Is it wouldn't have made a difference. Gyro does cool. In time for those outposts in 15 seconds. Meanwhile, top army could stop Ramses from getting this and snatch it back himself. So they might get both outposts.
Be a dangerous outcome for EG. Ramses getting tossed back.
So hanging around bot. Someone doesn't have Dream Core, but he'll move quickly across to secure that outpost. Meanwhile, the top lane, Arme and Nova will do the same. So both outposts going their way. Or is it? No, the Terrorize comes out. They turn around the Somnus. They drag him. He's dead. 30 seconds on the sideline, EG refused to give up that glorious XP. Do get themselves an outpost. And look at this. We wonder what Crit was doing with this gold. He invests into a Veil, not even boots.
First item, Veil of Discord. I mean, when you've got all this magic damage coming through, why not? You've got Fly, picks up a level 6 from a result of taking that outpost on the bot side. See how quickly the response comes through to build up pipe.
Both sides making those kind of interesting choices. We mentioned the urn already on FY, and now another hero just refusing boots. But Crit, the value is a bit easy to achieve. You have a lot of heroes with a lot of damage that gets amped up by the Veil. Gyro especially, even the Storm with long-range ball lightnings. Even Crystal Maiden, if you find a good position for a Freezing Field with the Veil up, anyone on LGD could die.
Just wondering, let's have a look at what CM's got queued up next. Oh, she's got the broom handle sitting in her inventory right now, but
hey, that's good
I
armor.
Guess, yeah, give it to the Abaddon, you know? He's the one that can actually benefit from the range.
Yeah, but he's a long way on the other side of the map. We don't want to go there yet. If we're EG, we want to make a play. They have a smoke. They've checked for vision, so it should be safe to smoke up here if they want to go. The question is, does Gyro want to leave all this farm? He doesn't.
Of course
and
not.
They might jump him because LGD have their own smoke. We'll break. FY, Tornado through, EMP there as well. CM, here up at the Cold Snap. Will be the easy pickoff for them. Tries to stick up to stay alive, but the Cold Snap still run. The urn, it's going to be a kill.
Presumably a pity. Somnus dodging out that frostbite.
was gonna say the good news is they didn't use smoke at least on EG, so it wasn't like they done that and then instantly lost in their own smoke. So they can still look to do it again when they're up.
I don't think they were too keen to, just because they, I mean, look at our team. He's happy to farm constantly throughout the entire jungle. He wants to catch up despite having crit and fly in his lane, leeching experience for a lot of the time.
That's the critical moment to start doing so, because Arbed almost has the level 2 ball lightning, which is where he should start to get active in the fights.
And just having a look at the level difference across the map, it's Arbed clearly in lead, nearly reached, like you said, is level 12. Puck not yet level 10, and a bit more even across the top side of for the
Chalice? On he has to split early. I find crit now. And crit does have terrorize, but can't use it due to the cold snap. They're going to jump forward. CM just got back to the lane, and Fly might be going back to base quicker than expected. Cycloned up and dragged down into a big fat mess. They'll find the kill into him, and they should be able to take the tower afterwards. With LGD, converge on the bot lane. Go for max impact. And that is a mech on an Undying, by the way. What? What's going on in this game? So many of these heroes do not have boots.
I mean, if the enemy doesn't have boots, you don't.
This is a game where a CM is actually one of the fastest heroes.
He's in big trouble on the top side.
We had to bring him down. He knows there's no escape from that. They were thinking about picking off a bot as well, but Ramsey still does have that bar of time. But FY, at least bleed all of his mana dry so that Ramsey can't protect himself. Good pickoffs. LGD keeping the activity up, ensuring that EG get punished for having one of their cores always farming.
Yeah, and now as a result of that early lead, you can see Ame rotating through to their tri-camp area, getting the Yasha early on. He's building into the Sanji as well for that sweet, sweet status resistance. That Mask of Man is accelerating further.
Such a good item in this type of game as well, because most of EG's damage is not physical. As we're seeing, one of the people used has a lot of magic damage in the mid lane, about to go down to exactly that primarily. Throw out the Cursed Crown. Ame is about to stun up his teammate. Nap time not advised. Terrorize comes out as well. They're chasing with a bull lightning to find two pickoffs quickly. A mistake by Ame there, running into FY, ensuring that they're both stunned up and both do go down.
Going way too deep there. Like I said before, that double stun. What you want at this stage of the game, absolutely, when you had that early game advantage. See now the power of Ramsey's being able to use that Abaddon with the Curse of Avernus to push forwards, and you don't need a hero like a Lycan to be able to quickly take out objectives on the map.
Oh, sorry, just one good fight and then you can push in like that. I still own the only tower so far that they've taken. They haven't prioritized the outer towers on the side of EG. Something you probably want to do in the next 5 minutes is you're halfway towards the next outpost XP boost.
Yeah, I feel like these days the side lane towers are so much more important than previously. Maybe even more important than towers. What objectives really want around the side of the map? Nothing really. You know, it doesn't Roche quite as much as it used to. Got those towers still to TP to, and I just think the outposts are way higher priority. Snowball more and more. Games are faster and faster. You need that early advantage more than.
That's why we've seen a lot of these kind of heroes like DK Pugner prioritizing an experiment with going to the out lanes instead of trying to push in the mid. Just trying to leverage that outpost timing to also take a
town. They found Ame.
Yeah, down half HP. It looks like he won't get away. Yeah, for 25 seconds, but LGD's still looking to go in right now. Whole snap was already used. Tornado through. Wool clip, thanks to the stomp. And Maiden might go down. Chalice might have to use the split. Taking a lot of damage. Freezing Field doing decent work. But now Fly will die. The movement in with the science to ensure that Somnus. Let's get the Dream Call out. Control on the Storm Spirit. Can they kill him off? Arbed might have the time to move away with the ball lightning, but the stun follow-up is good. However, they haven't got the damage to follow through. Instead, Puck's going to go down. FY's chasing on two next, and Arbed gets himself on a killing spree. Chalice might be the next to fall, trying to take Arbed with him, but won't be so lucky. The one is enough to heal him up, ball lightning him around, and ensure that Brewmaster is the one that should be going down.
Very, very happy. I mean, that's the result of leaving Arteezy to farm for a little bit. You give him a minutes, and he'll take a mile from it. Not really a good analogy, but anyway, it was a really good team fight for EG, being able to come back into things and, you know, despite still having the lower end of the kill score, now been more efficient with the time that they're able to have. Even crit coming a bit back more into the game after being, I don't want to say useless early on, but the heroes that they were coming up against, so hard to be able to.
It's the way he played the early game, right? Like, he wasn't like, okay, I'm gonna find loads of kills in the lane. He's like, just give me a lane. Then I'll get one or two items, I'll get the levels, and then I can start finding solo pickoffs for you. And also drawing a lot of their attention, apparently, as they try to kill Crit again, barely put a dent in him. He also has the Philosopher's Stone, so... mini GPM talent for the support. He had to get himself towards Yules pretty quickly at this rate. And because...
yeah, they pick both of them up at the exact same time, those Philosopher's Stones, so supports very, very happy with it all.
Yep. Next Nova, we already mentioned he has the mech, heading towards the Vlad's neck. She's going to be the Aura Builder, which can free up Brood to be a little bit more aggressive with his build. He's going towards the pipe, though, after the Helmet Dom now. I wondered if he might try and opt for something a bit more greedy because Undying's filling the gaps.
Maybe, but I just think there's an insane amount of magic potential coming out from EG, as well as that Veil of Discord on Dark Willow, that you need the pipe. It's just a non-negotiable.
Most definitely. And now...
catching out Ramsey's in mid.
Ice Ball goes down. You burn all his mana, but how do you kill him in time? I don't think you do. They just want to force him out of the lane so they can maybe push him for this tier 1 tower. 2 minutes until outposts are going to reap the rewards. LGD, they do move bot to secure one. However, Arbed is keeping top pushed in to ensure that they can't go and try and grab a second. Oh, perfect drop, Vambrace. Only one Wraith Band though on Arteezy's. You did find that Aquila. Someone's going
to
buy it.
Sending another one out. He's got the BKB first and foremost. And Ramsey's and Arbed are doing exactly what they need. But Ramsey's standing perhaps further forward than he should be. But as a result of that, getting this three-man rotation onto him, he doesn't die. And Arteezy's just been using his cooldown to farm neutral camp. They're getting far more out of the map.
Yeah, and they've got items that say they are ready to fight. The Sanj is nice for Tiny, but it doesn't change too much of what he's doing. Same time, Somnus, he went for that Maelstrom. Heading for the BKB next, but ages away right now.
Yeah. See here, Arteezy, he's got that second Wraith Bag coming out to him, as well as a TP scroll to make sure he can join in on any team fight that's coming next. I would guess that maybe LGD might try and make something happen towards the top outpost, but I feel like they've got the sense that playing a little bit behind.
It would be risky. I don't think they spotted that TP out by Crit. It was just out of range, so even if they see Arbed, they don't know if he's alone. Instead, there's a smoke movement. EG moving in. Ramses is dangling, but no one is here to receive it. It's LGD. They're split across the map.
TPing down to the bottom side, just saying, look, if you want to play around the area that you feel you control, we'll just do the exact same. We're going to push down, we're going to try and take down this tier 2 tower, because a big factor of this patch is that there's no shrine now in the Radiant Jungles. If you take this tier 2 tower, it becomes very, very difficult for them to contest this bottom outpost.
And they just let LGD play with themselves.
They know.
Yeah, they do know. Can they get across quick enough, though? They're coming. They're smoked. Arme does see an arcane rune. Somnus says, yes, please. I don't think EG can do this. They need to back away right now. This could backfire very easily. If they hold the high ground, maybe they can catch LGD out instead. Somnus does have that arcane rune.
Especially now with Arbed just sitting on half mana pool right now. Dangerous situation to be in. Yeah, they've got the BKB up here on Arteezy, but perhaps he might feel a little bit more confident if he gets that level 15, gets that little bit of extra damage that allows them to take Roshan a bit more confident.
It's just the nuisance of LGD. Even with the BKB, the rest of your team suffers, right? Like, you're up against an Invoker who doesn't have to prioritize his levels in gold because it's a support. Same time,
another smoke coming
up. Can turn up. And they said smoke straight back in. EG, they need this so badly. They realize that with the BKB being picked up so early, they want to try and maximize their aggression at the 20-25 minute mark. The pings are coming out.
Got a really nice clever ward here from the Dire that they just placed.
Tombstone. Nope. Silence straight away. The root comes out to Brewmaster as well. The Terrorizer bomb enough time. They'll be able to finish off the Roach without interruption. Magus gets picked up by Arteezy. You're going to chase him right now. Dreamcore going to come out, but they don't care. They'll stand to fight. Tiny's going to get down already, and they need to fight up against this. The buyback's going to come up for Tiny. But Invoker getting low on HP. Arbed up on the high ground, trapped behind the Tombstone, pinged out, but we'll be able to bull lightning away and get the kill into FY. It's a buyback on the Tiny. Invoker dead as well, but you're not finding anything for it. X-Nova has to run away. Abaddon will pop his ultimate. He's the borrowed time to run off. Chalice in a little bit deep. But both splits off laners, they don't want to fight. They just look at each other, they nod heads, and they say, back to your side, sir.
EG more than happy with that, getting the Aegis onto the Gyrocopter, getting two kills and forcing the buyback out of the safe lane carry. Can't expect much more than that with this stage of the game. And Snowbird a little bit slow to pop that mechanism. I thought maybe Tiny would have been able to get off a little bit of extra damage or maybe pop off a couple of his spells. I didn't see if they were on cooldown or not, if he was able to survive that time longer.
It also looked like they wanted to stick the Aegis on Abed. Like, he ran into the pit as if he wanted to pick it up, but Arteezy, he wasn't having any shenanigans. He didn't wait around.
In a hectic situation like that, you can't give LGD anything. They will exploit every opportunity.
But they're trying to exploit the attempts for Arteezy to take this bot outpost, but because he has that Aegis, not a target. Especially with Ramzes in the neighborhood. In fact, EG might just be coming for this bot tier 1. They don't know how many heroes are behind these two. It's only crit so far. Arbed going on top will reveal that. But Fly is connecting towards the bot lane, so they're ready to fight if need be. They'd rather just get the objectives and continue to increase their lead, because right now, LGD, the pressure is on them to make plays.
Yeah, they're trying their best to do so, but again, it's just on Arteezy, and they've already taken the tier 1, so hoping to just count their winnings and back off. Go back to farming the jungle.
Not for long, though. Got plenty of time left in the Aegis. They could even try and push him for the tier 2s. It's all space for Arbed as well.
I'm interested to see if they choose to do this now. You know, obviously Aegis still has 3 minutes or so left on it. Or are they going to be able to quickly farm up the remainder of Arteezy tags in that time? 2,000 gold away, so it's wishful thinking, but...
Tornado coming out. Burns the mana, will run away in time. It should be pointed out that EG are playing blind on the map as well. Like, this is how confident they feel. They haven't got any vision down. Some of it's due to dewarding, but mostly they're just not bringing it with them. They'll finally throw out an obs now. But you saw that. They just run up the high grounds. They feel so confident with Zagus, and LGD are just playing a game of dodge. Question is, where do you prioritize vision for a push?
It's such a different thing, right? From the early game, like the laning stage, I guess it always is going to be that way with an Undying, to where it is now. It feels like EG is in complete control, and you have to play a little bit scared with Ame having used his buyback previously on the Tiny. It's still down for another 5 minutes, so kind of don't even want to try and take objective. We're always playing on the back foot, although five of them converging around this top side. No T1 tower to take, but trying to pressure some movement out of EG.
They're trying to see if they can actually punish the split, right? Because it's always Abed off pushing a different lane and then four stacked behind either Gyro or Abed. But most of the time, it's obvious that it's the Gyro right now because they want to try and push a big advantage off a big fight. The question is, what are you waiting for in LGD? What is the big item that allows you to just propel yourself? They're going for the BKBs. Again, closer on Ame, and they have now got it on Park. Who is going towards the Axe next? The perfect choice considering you expect EG to start stacking BKBs quickly. We're seeing how much the Storm is hurt by those Dream Calls. Oh, come on.
Oh.
I mean, it's always on these heroes. Oh, jump in, long range. Ame in a bit of trouble. He needs to move away, but can't do so quick enough, and he's going to go down. As you said, he bought back previously, so he's dead, asleep for 75 seconds. And this is where EG can look to just take down tier 2 towers.
River was in a risky position right there. But, able to get the ward off. Instant ward. Fire. And now, just continuing to push forward. They know there's absolutely nothing to worry about. FY is doing his best. Wisely on the top side of the map, it's Chalice trying to get every little scrap that he can out of this free time that he has. They were never going to contest that tier 2 tower. It's just a matter of what's got in sights next.
Yeah, you have to forfeit the fact that two of these towers are dropping, but you can at least stop it from being free by controlling that top wave. Good move by him. And I do believe I just heard an Aegis being reclaimed, but there's no way the LGD fight without the Tiny, so this just might be the tier 2 forfeit. Gold League building as well. I'll try to slow it down a little bit, but it's just inevitability at this stage. There's just so much anarchy about the way that EG zones you away, with the cooldowns, with the bramble mazes, with the threat terrorize. And always this frustrating Abaddon just up in your face saying, hit me, please.
Interesting skill build by Fly as well. Hasn't put any points into his first tier talent. I felt like that was something that he did into the health. I thought he might try and prioritize the cast range because he's already got the keen optic. So you can actually catch out LGD by surprise by having that little extra reach, frostbite, catch the puck out in a situation where just by muscle memory, maybe might think, you know, I'm safe.
The bigger problem is the BKBs though, right? Like, you knew they were coming out. Somnus has had his a few minutes. You expect there to be another one on Tiny. So I can kind of get behind why he didn't rush it. You also know that Chalice is probably going for a BKB as well. But those earlier points, mm-hmm. your nukes just farm up. That's one of the big benefits. Just when you see the opportunity to shove in a lane, also helps you kill heroes still. Crit, by the way, is up to the level 15. He has got the GPM talent with the Philosopher's Stone still, so look at him accelerate. He's just past Chalice. He's going to start to turn to a core himself.
And that's what happens when you give someone their signature heroes. Already got the GPM talent, like I said, so that's an extra 180 gold per he's able to grab.
And it's also fully invested, right? If you look on Chalice, while he has an Ogre Club, that gold is deceptive. Whereas when you look at Crit, he's going to have the Guardian Greaves flying out now, which is going to give more push power to LGD and the ability to fight sooner. And with Roche potentially being up in a minute's time, that becomes a critical factor, especially when you're talking about these kind of burst type heroes, right? Where you got the nukes coming out from the Puck and the Tiny. Like, what is your entrance skill now? Even the CM picking up that health talent and having the Glimmer Cape, it's very hard to find an easy pick off on the EG. It feels like you're still looking at Arbed maybe and trying to punish him when he split pushes.
And even now, the Mindbreaker. So if you're catching out any of these cores that don't have the BKB built up...
Jump in. Invoker. Dream Call coming out onto the Storm Spirit. The TPs are still coming. They need to get him out. He barely stays alive there. Just about gets Invis with 100 HP left. But that's Dream Call gone.
The retreat for now.
Yeah, you have to calm down all of a sudden. Now, if it's a quick spawn, then the gods do not favor LGD. As at this point, EG, it maybe takes them like 30 seconds to melt Roche.
Yeah. Damage coming out from the Dark Willow. Enchanted Quiver of everything else. I think it's going to be way too much for LGD to deal with.
Okay, looks like the gods favor like LGD. They gave him a quickening charm and enough time to get the Dream Call ready. It's enough time for the Dream Call. It will be enough time for Puck to farm his Ags as well, by the way. This wave will get him it, and then all of a sudden EG could be in a lot of trouble if they get caught in the pit. And they might feel confident, right? They don't know if he's there at the Ags yet, and if they just rush into the pit, they get caught with three heroes, even the BKBs won't protect them.
Okay. See that. Picked it up just now. They're waiting around. Hopefully, if they can grab the tome, they want to grab that over to the Puck as soon as possible, because at this point, it's all about turning her into a carry. Her own right. You can't put everything to armor. The burst is great, but there needs to be sustained damage as well.
Yeah, he's the follow through. Like, you actually have to look at Puck in these weird scenarios as kind of your opening pickoff. Not even based necessarily on the magical damage, but the physical to get him over the mark. Then you take a good fight, Arme can just push in. Then nowhere nearby. They just gave EG a freebie. Aegis and Cheese going their way, and that is a Storm lineup with Aegis. Jeez. It's gonna get a little bit rough. Like, you've already given up all your tier 2s as well. So, EG, they have a clear objective. They can just go straight for your base when they want to. If they find that DD as well. They are as well. Arbed's walking up river. Oh, a tree. You saw that hesitation for a moment. It's like, wait.
Still there?
Is this a bait? They know how badly I would love a DD right now.
Kind of was. They smoked actually on LGD's side. Only X-Men still sitting on it.
Things will calm down for a moment, but LGD, they might feel this pressure to try and find a pickoff before the main engagement kicks off. And you already see the EG are split up. They're doing the same thing over and over again, and LGD have seen this time and time again. Gyro in one lane, Storm Spirit in another. And this time, the roles have shifted. This time, it's the support sitting behind their Storm, and RTZ is the one farming alone.
Just out of range when using that smoke as well. So, got the element of surprise here. Got to pick off Undying.
Gone. No chance to even hit the mech. Things come out. They could go for the long range ball lightning onto Arme. He does have the BKB though. They need to wait for the vortex before they jump. And he'll TP out in time.
Wisely as well by the Puck, pushing out that mid lane as much as he can. It's going to delay it a little bit. You would think the Undying is going to be a factor for any sort of team fight coming up next when they're pushing here onto this high ground.
also love the way that Ramzes is the carrier of this AWP destruction. He's just able to get in, chip away a little every time. There's no real pressure, because if you're forcing yourself to commit onto this Abaddon, you've already lost the fight. But alright, thanks. You done a little bit of damage. Time to lifesteal that all back up, and we'll do it again.
Yeah. Got his Lotus Orb delivered as well before the courier went down, so can't be too unhappy. You got what he wanted.
Like, who will die? Like, what will happen first? Will I run out of health, or will you run out of mana? It'll be a close one. Gyro is just farming up, though. It seems like EG are content to let this go later and later. Toss back. Ramzes doesn't feel good about it anymore, though. Being tossed that deep, has the Lotus Orb. Does have the borrowed time, we'll have to pop it. And he'll have to reset, have the tornado. Get sidestepped.
You've got Arteezy nearby, though.
Yeah, if they come out to play, they might be in a little bit of trouble. And Arme feels confident about this. This may be his mistake. Maybe his downfall. Terrorize. Being charged up. Will be held in the end. Face shift to dodge out. There's a full lightning in by Arme. They stab the back line, though. FY healed up by the Saw Rip. But it's going to come out. But BKB activated by Arteezy. Will look to melt through the Brulings. It will actually force the buyback straight away out on FY. But he's far away from the fight. Trying to get across in time. Dream Call is going to come out. Just on the one. Abaddon, though. The target. No borrowed time for 10 seconds. The Terrorize to scare them away. Won't be good enough. And now, Tiny being burst through. Doesn't have the BKB anymore. Will go down. Arbed chasing for more. Looking forward onto the park. Who is silenced up. Should be falling as well. The damage overwhelms him and kills him off. And the root is out. On the Brewmaster. Chalice the next to hit the deck. And LGD hemorrhaging one kill off the other. Enables EG just outside the base to go in and start hitting buildings.
And the snowball just keeps coming and coming. They've got the Aghanim Scepter built up on the Gyrocopter, not even forcing him to use the cheese. Still has the Aegis here on Arbed as well, and that Bloodstone doing so much work. He's regenerating nearly 100 mana per second previously.
He's looking for more. But LGD, they're wise to this. They're giving a wide buff right now. They realize it's not the game if they lose this lane. But if they take an awkward fight, it could be.
I feel like LGD have kind of resigned themselves to this loss. We saw FY try and Sunstrike the one range creep that was kind of protecting against any sort of backdoor protection, but it wasn't enough. Got two lanes pushing into the LGD base. Still going to be 30 seconds until they're ready to take any sort of counteraction.
And EG will not sell for anything less than two lanes, and they won't have to. Hawk's still dead for 10 seconds. They want to have to buy back. Tiny doesn't have it available either, so... they'll just get away with it. They'll back off. They say.
Troll.
I was about to say, like, you know, no Aegis used. It's about to be claimed soon anyway. So if LGD want to make a move, it's now. This almost feels like you're close to desperation smoke play, right? Like, you should be smoking up and out the base to try and find someone to retreat. Because if you just wait around, it might just be the same issue again where you give a free Roche over to EG.
Yeah, I mean, I thought it felt very healthy. All ultimates back online. Except for the Dark Willow, which was up in 10 seconds, but seems like they're happy to just back off for now. They're not going to have that Aegis for the next counter. 10 seconds, as you said. You're in big trouble, though. 23k net worth lead at the 35-minute mark is nearly insurmountable.
Dot Plus basically says it's insurmountable. 99% chance to win. Oh. Aegis has been reclaimed, and that's the moment where Storm exploits it to the maximum to regen up. Little in and out. He's his own little takeaway at this point.
Imagine if he was 25 at that point. He would have tried to just get all of those remnants.
Probably would have found a kill actually as well. Like Nova was close by. So. Instead, they'll back off, push in on the lanes, and force LGD to come out on the map and make a mistake. They might make a mistake here, Arme. It's gonna be an easy BKB forcage. Moving in. And Abaddon's here as well. Tornado to zone them away, though. So he doesn't have to use the BKB, because that could be costly if so. Toss in, but Ramzes is fine. Lotus will return the Homing Missile to Sender. So they do back off. However, top lane is pushing in. Mid is pushing in. It's just time being dragged away from the other lanes.
Crit has 5,000 gold as well. He hasn't spent yet, so... oh, the double catch.
Terrorize. Scares them away further, and the Bedlam comes out. Decent damage being done, but the Tornado by a little bit of time. The Bull Lightning's through, trying to get him blown up. We'll find the kill on Undying. Tiny's low, Arme forced to fight like this. It's bad for him, though. He does get the kill to Willow, but we'll go down for it. Now Somnus, in deep, needs to retreat quickly. Trying to get up the high ground with the Waning Rift just in time. One more hit was all that was needed. He does survive. They forced the buyback out of Tiny, though, and there's no overcommitment. EG, Willow was already going down like that. That's a big buyback coming out from LGD, and now a clear win condition for EG.
Clear win condition, as you said, and Chalice, he was just sitting nearby. I feel like today is not the day for the offlaners most of the time. Seen some questionable plays all throughout. Now some of that burst damage is coming through with the Chrysalis picked up from the puck. You've got the, of course, the phase shift attack coming. You've got the Enchanted Quiver, so it's all happening all at once, but... No, I don't think it's gonna be enough. Too little, too late.
Everyone's just a little bit too tanky. You look at the lineup, they have decent sustain. Ways to dispel, Lotus Orbs, Aphotic Shields, Guardian Greaves to heal them up. And of course, there's BKBs. Yeah, let's not forget Satanics at the end of all. Because, you know, if it wasn't like they've been kicked in the nuts already, let's just add in the fact that Gyro is going to sustain quicker and longer than the tiny can in these fights.
I mean, he was doing a decent amount of work in that, just with his marker man hacking away at anyone that stood up towards him, but still not enough. He's nearly going to pick up that AC, though, it seems. Building into, yeah. 300 gold away, that could turn the tide of the battle.
I like how they give him a broom handle after all this time. Like, yeah, here you go. Took a while. We realized this is good on you, by the way. And Roche might be up in 5 seconds. LGD.
Surely they wouldn't do that.
No. Surely Gaben wouldn't do such a thing. Do the gods bless it? 3 minutes. LGD, get a lifeline. However, Summers has just been forced to use the BKB. He needs to back away right now. We'll get out. You might see EG try and exploit this, though. Bot lane. They won't be able to find FY. He'll get away in time. They're just trying to strip control. They're happy to wait for the Roche. They probably won't be as happy when they realize how long the timer is. But they've got Corio watching for the very moment that it comes up. And look at this. LGD out the base again. Crit. Throws out the Hex. Onto Arme. Terrorize as well, but he decides against it. Stun doesn't last that long in the end. Jump in, Dream Core comes down. Now the ball lightning in with the Vortex. Good control. The cooldown follow up as well. Force out the BKB because the Terrorize doesn't clip in time. But RTZ is in. The Fear is out. Puck is down. So is FY. Nova being chased onto will be found by RTZ while he also farms up the Tombstone. And look at this. Arme's BKB has ran out. Flies, however, is looking juicy and long enough to bring down the Tiny as he will fall. That is the dieback they were looking for. And they can just roll into the base of LGD as they call the GG.
I mean, good timing on a bunch of different things there from LGD. Even getting the lucky... Oh, gets the Rampage in the last second. But EG, they just had such a snowballing style draft. Everything worked